Now we're getting our first look at some photos showing injuries a local teenager says are the result of police brutality. We want to warn you, these are disturbing. 18-year-old Jordan Miles, a senior at Pittsburgh's Creative and Performing Arts High School, says he was beaten by plainclothes police officers in Homewood 9 days ago. Channel 4 Action News reporter John Greiner is live in the newsroom now with the latest on this. John.
The teen's mom says they may consider a civil lawsuit, but first they're dealing with the criminal case. Jordan is charged with assaulting two police officers. He says it was the other way around. Tonight, 18-year-old Jordan Miles still shows the effects of a run-in with Pittsburgh police he can't understand.
I'm not on the street. I don't have a record. I never had a problem with the police before.
The criminal complaint states on the night of January 12th, as Jordan says he was going to his grandmother's, three undercover police officers suspected he had a gun and saw him run. Jordan says they grabbed and beat him and describes his injuries.
At that time, my face was really numb. I was in the snow. They just pushed my face in the snow. But when I went to jail, it began to, fall out. I was able to feel everything. It was throbbing. I had a headache. I was dripping blood everywhere. The pain was tremendous.
Miles says police found no gun, no drugs, and nothing that looks like a gun on him. A police spokesperson says the case has been referred to OMI for a complete investigation. As for Jordan's mother, she wants to know why police would target her son, a senior who plays the viola at Pittsburgh's Performing Arts High School.
I want to know what made those three police officers stop my son that night and beat him to a pulp for no reason.
Jordan Miles' attorney said the police were not in uniform and Jordan ran because he didn't know who they were. In the affidavit, police say they punched and kicked him because he was resisting arrest, for which he's charged. Live in the newsroom, John Greiner, Channel 4 Action News.